Iranian engineer Jalal Rouhollahnejad was released on Friday, following extensive negotiations between Iranian security officials and French authorities. His release comes despite a French court ruling that approved his extradition to the United States to face charges of attempting to import U.S. technology. Speaking to Press TV, the Iranian engineer reaffirmed his innocence and thanked those who secured his release.
I would like to thank the IRGC's intelligence unit, the Iranian embassy in France, and many others who worked around the clock to secure my release after 14 months in unlawful captivity. This includes those who had to travel more than 1,000 kilometers to do the paperwork for me. I was invited to do a research on an underground water project along with three other university lecturers. I never thought they would treat me like this, especially over the false charges of violating U.S. sanctions.
Pundits called Ruhollahnejad's release from custody a major diplomatic victory for Iran and its security and judicial system. They say it's yet another case in which a U.S. ally ignored a request from Washington to extradite an Iranian national.
Despite all the beautiful words about human rights, they treated me very badly during detention. Although my lawyer said I hadn't committed any crime, they shackled me and transferred me to a prison outside Paris. After 26 days, I was allowed to phone my family.
On Friday, Iran also agreed to the conditional release of a French national who had been detained on espionage charges. Iranian security officials agreed to a request to lower Roland Gabriel Marshal's sentence following the French government's cooperation on the release of Ruhollahnejad. The Frenchman was handed over to the French embassy in Tehran. He left the Iranian capital for Paris early on Saturday.
This is not the first time that Iran has won a historic legal battle against the United States and its illegal sanctions regime against the Islamic Republic. Officials here say it won't be the last time. Aman Nodiri, Press TV, Tehran.